Hello, my name's Jake. I'm a missionary in southern Brazil at an orphanage, and I just wanted to share with you about how I built my solar water heater. In Brazil, water is usually heated at the shower head with an instant water heater in the shower head. It uses a lot of electricity, about 5,000 watts, and in the winter it usually isn't enough to make a warm shower. Usually it's a cool shower. So I decided to build a solar water heater. But before I get into it, first, just a little bit about the location. We're 25 degrees away from the equator. That would be a similar distance from the equator as the Florida Keys. We're also 3,500 feet up, about 1,000 meters in altitude. So even though we don't get the same hot climate as the Florida Keys do, in the summer, usually it doesn't get up above 90 degrees. The hottest month, the average temperature is 70 degrees. In the winter, it will get below freezing, but not enough to ever freeze the pipes, which is very nice. Also, just a little bit more about the location. The yearly average temperature is 61 degrees. So that means the water, as it comes through the pipes in the ground, gets into the water tank at about 60 degrees Fahrenheit or 16 or 17 degrees Celsius. So a good shower is about 105 degrees Fahrenheit or 40 degrees Celsius. So I needed to get the temperature up and make up as much as I could to get up to that temperature. And this water heater on cloudy days will get up to 90 degrees, even if there's cloudy days, even on rainy days. It'll get up to 90 degrees. And then on days with sun, it'll easily get up to 135 degrees. When it gets up to 90 degrees on the electric shower head, I just turn it on halfway. Ever since we've had it installed, I've only ever put it on full blast once, the shower. So, just a little bit about how the solar hot water heater is made. We just get a close-up then of how I did it. So I use PVC pipe. PVC pipe is only rated to go 55 degrees Celsius or 135 degrees Fahrenheit. I believe that limit is there because of the joints in the PVC. The connections will fail at that temperature. Now here we have low pressure, just as much pressure as there is fall from the hot water tank, which is up in our attic. Now, what I did to make the hot water heater, I stuck T's together with small pipes in the middle. So I have a row of T's here and a row of T's up there. Then, inside this glass, you can see here, there is a fluorescent light bulb tube. I cleaned out all of the dust that was inside so that it became a clear, long piece of glass, and I punctured both ends so that I could get a 20 millimeter or a half inch pipe to go inside of it. And I have about 32 of these pipes. The square footage of the collector is 2728 square feet or 2.5 square meters. And it's a thermosyphon. As the water, cold water, comes in through here, this is the lowest point on the collector. It is heated as it goes through these pipes, and because water becomes less dense with more heat, it rises and rises up until the highest point, as this is not level, it's on an angle, which is over there, and then it goes up into the top of the water tank. The cold water then replaces it, flows down from the bottom of the water tank into this part, and it just cycles. I did two tests. I'm using the fluorescent bulbs as an insulator, basically a double glazing. It keeps hot air around it, so that allows it to be heated not just on 180 degrees of the pipe, but 360 degrees of the pipe, because it's not just radiation, but also the convection produced by the radiated heat. I did tests with the bulb around the pipe and without a bulb. With a bulb, within 45 minutes, the water heated from 60 degrees to 135 degrees Fahrenheit, or from 17 degrees Celsius to 55 degrees Celsius, within 45 minutes. Without the bulb, it only heated up to 125 degrees Fahrenheit. And so it added extra efficiency to the heater by putting on the fluorescent bulb. And on those days when I did those tests, there was not a lot of sun. Usually, for most of the day, you couldn't see your shadow. It was partly cloudy. And then, to protect the PVC connections from the heat, I covered all connections in foam insulation, and then over the foam insulation, because the sun deteriorates foam insulation, I put tin foil and then painted it black to help absorb more heat. This way, it sturdies the PVC connections, and it also protects them from the extra heat that is in here. The only heat that will reach it should be the heat of the water as it flows through. Well, in North America, this wouldn't be the best system because you can't put antifreeze in it. Your drinking water flows through it and then back into a water tank. It does have some uses. For example, it would be good for a pool shower in the winter. It could be winterized very easily. This is the lowest section of the water heater. I can just open up this pipe, drain all the water out, and then put a tarp over the top so that it won't overheat when it doesn't have any water in it. It could also be used as a heater at a cabin, just things that would be used during the summer. That way the water could be drained out in the winter to avoid it freezing. Now, let's go inside and take a look in the attic at how I have the water tank set up. Here we are in the attic. This is my water tank. You can kind of see it here. It's a 310 liter or about 82 gallon tank. It's just a standard cold water tank. It's almost like Tupperware. I have 5 pipes going in and out of it. In the back, it's kind of hard to see. I have the pipe that feeds it cold water. This pipe here is an overflow pipe. That way you can never spill it into the house. It takes the water out to the soffit. This pipe feeds the house with hot water. It is on top of, this is the return from the solar hot water heater. This is the supply of cold water to the solar hot water heater. The reason this pipe that feeds the plumbing in the house is the tallest is that way there's always going to be water going inside the solar hot water heater. Even if my pump fails and doesn't fill my tank up and I use all of the water, I can only use the water to this level. That way my solar hot water heater can't overheat because it's run out of water. Another thing that I've done is, and there'll be a link hopefully below this when I put it on YouTube, is you can see this power cord going in. Here's the other end of it, just regular power cord. Inside, I bought a trough heater. Actually, it's a bucket heater. It turns on at 80 degrees Fahrenheit and off at 110 degrees Fahrenheit. This way, it's kind of like a backup. Now, in cold days, if I needed to, I could have electrically heated hot water. I've also insulated it with spray foam insulation. I prefer fiberglass, but I could not find a cheap, quick source of that here in Brazil. The box or the water tank is not completely insulated. Once I get more money, I'll be able to do that. Now, if you come down here into the bathroom, I can show you somewhat of a standard Brazilian shower head. This shower head has a heating element in it right here. It runs at 5,000 watts. This one has 3 adjustments. It can run at 2,500 watts, 5,000 watts, or 7,500 watts. And then the heating element heats it instantly and it comes out here. So it's just a simple source of hot water. Most Brazilian houses have one of these. And it's great when you have a solar hot water heater, because on the days when it's cloudy, I can just turn it on a third of the way and it'll heat the water. I don't have to put it on full blast. So it saves a lot in electricity. Standard Brazilian houses would have a 5,000 watt shower head, which is equivalent to 5,100 watt light bulbs on at the same time, or 4 microwaves. So it's quite a bit of electricity to be used. So by having a solar hot water heater, I can greatly reduce the electric bill